What is up, guys? Dr. GT, and I'm finally back in GTA 5, and as you can see behind me, that's not the ordinary train. No, it's not. That is a Union Pacific big boy steam locomotive, and it's coal-fired. This thing is 132 feet long. Insane. And guess what? It's super sweet. It has four wheels in the front, eight drive wheels, which are these big black ones that push it, and it has eight more in the back, and then another four is the same. So it's 4884. This thing's massive. It weighs 762,000 pounds. It even has the name of the locomotive printed on the side of it. That's how good this is. Basically today, join me, because we're about to drive this train in Train Sim World, which is GTA 5. And as you can see on the front, it has a bell, and it has a 4014, which is distinguishing the number of the 4000 series class locomotive. This thing is amazing, guys. These were used until 1959 in the World War II to help get stuff over for Pearl Harbor. That's the cab we're looking at. There's actually a driver in it. It's super amazing, guys. And then here, this is the tender, which is using coal to fire it. It has a chamber in it. Pretty cool. And we're going to be running a double heading today. If you don't know what that is, join me and find out, because we're about to take this in our Train Sim World in the snow, because it's about to snow, so we better head out while we still can, because this is amazing. We're going to do two trains pulling this huge load all the way down there of freight. We got to get it down to Los Santos and get it in there before the snow hits, but maybe we might not catch it, and we might catch the snow, so who knows. Just join me, because it's going to be awesome today. This is the first train mod of its kind, and I'm super excited to share it with you. Special thanks to my friend Nib Mods for making it possible. Let's go ahead and jump over into the inside of the train and check it out. So you hold the button down, F, to jump in the train. The link to the script is in the description, by the way, to get this mod working. Not that it's not bad, but yeah. So we're going ahead and we're going to go into the cab view, and I'm going to show you what it looks like inside the cab. It's pretty, pretty sweet. Here's the cab, and it has all the valve cylinder heads, and everything's already working. It's super awesome. Some of the stuff even works, and you can move it. There's a cab driver. We're going to be kicking him out in a second, but we're going to get moving because we have to get out of here, and we'll figure that out in a second. But the cab is amazing. Let's go ahead and push on out of here and let's get stuff going and check out these effects. Well, all right, we are now moving at slow mile an hour speed, but we got to do that until we can get out of this place, because we are in the train station and we can't go over, I think, 30 or 25. Now, a little bit more on this locomotive. This thing is a really cool locomotive. It's actually been in a lot of history books, and I'm super excited to actually have it in GTA 5, because it's not only like a train sim, we can actually finally drive trains and get out of them and get in them and walk around the world of GTA 5. Not like these other train simulator games, which you get in the train and you can't get out of it, you can't walk around the world. It's super amazing to even have this possible, and I'm so happy. This is my favorite locomotive of all. And as you can see, it has steam coming out the top of it, because this is actually using a boiler. It's actually using a boiler that heats up coal, fires it, makes pressure, and the steam actually powers the cylinders that are pushing those wheels, those drive wheels. But it looks like we need to go ahead and get a little bit more power going, because you can see the snow is coming in right now. We need to get going. Now here's the inside. We definitely need to kick this guy out so we can drive a little faster. Let's kick him out. That's how you do it, Grand Theft Auto, baby. Now this is the inside of it. As you can see, there's a lot of pressure, temperature controls. There's two seats for other drivers and assistants. And then we have a handle up there to pull the horn. They have this regulator in front of me, which I'm gonna pull in a second, pull it all the way back, and we're gonna haul ass. We have some brake handles, and then we have some other stuff too, reverser and regulator. But we're gonna pull this regulator back because we need to get up to speed, baby. So let's get that up. Right, hell yeah. So we're now moving at an amazing 50 miles an hour, I think it is. either whatever it says at the top, but we need to keep moving because we gotta beat this blizzard, guys. Are we gonna beat this blizzard? I don't know, but we have two trains here, which, like I said, is called a double heading. I just found out all this stuff too, by the way, guys, so I'm new to the train thing. We are moving super fast. Look at those rods pushing this thing, man. Pushing those drive wheels. Oh, there's some horses. View from the cab again, pretty cool. And look, it looks like we already caught some snow. I've been driving for a little bit, but the snow looks amazing. I think you'll agree, won't you? And here comes the blizzard. Yep, I didn't think we were gonna catch it, but we gotta get through this. So we're gonna push it up a little bit and we're gonna go 60 or 50 through this until we can get to a curve and we have to slow down. And we gotta track to stop for, to make sure there's no cars, because we don't want to hit any cars, because we might hit some cars coming up this track. We gotta slow it down when we get up here. To the right of me is actually the highway, and then if we get over here in this other seat, you can see over, but there's nothing really to see on this side right now, so we're gonna switch back over to the main driver's seat right now. We're picking up speed now and we're moving super sweet. As soon as we get up to there, we'll have to slow our run down, and then I'll have to honk a long honk two times and then a short honk and then a long honk again, which is what I learned actually, how you honk a horn on a train. Now the reason, if you're probably wondering why we're using two trains like this, is because double heading means if you want to pull faster and more if it's a longer train and you need to get it there. And they used to do this back in World War II for the stuff they need to get to the west to get to Pearl Harbor whenever we were in the war. Oh, gotta slow it down, we're gonna grind. Whew, that was crazy, guys. See, oh, just like that, like I was saying, we could derail this train potentially with this mod. It'll derail the train if you go fast, so we gotta watch our speed and we gotta slow down. Oh, here comes, oh no, there's a car. Get out of the track, idiot. Woo, that guy almost got ran over right there. That is insane. What the heck? Woo, I would hate to hit someone in this thing because it won't stop. God, but that snow is still amazing though. It's pretty great. So we're gonna speed it up a little bit here. We're gonna go about 60, I'd say. 59, 60 miles an hour. Look at that, guys. 60 miles an hour in a steam locomotive. And not only that's a big boy, 4884. We gotta keep pushing this thing. We gotta get running. We gotta go. As you can see, I'm moving the regulator back and forth because you don't want a lot of pressure, especially when the tires, these actually have tires on these drive wheels and they slip. And if you didn't know this, the way the torque works on these, oh no. Ooh, the torque actually can make them slip in the snow, so you want to slow down, because as soon as it slips, it'll start spinning out like a car would. So you got to slow it down and let off the regulator, because if you don't, it'll break the train. It'll mess up the train. Now this locomotive weighs 762,000 pounds. The tender, which is that coal thing behind me, holding all the coal for the fuel, weighs 342,000 pounds. Total weight, 1,250,000 pounds. This thing holds 28 short tons of coal and 25,000 US gallons. Miles an hour, baby. Whoa, we are really moving now, guys. Whoa, check this thing out. Super moving. Sweet. Maybe we'll beat Santa to the train station. Who knows, guys? Actually, you're probably watching this after Christmas, and I'm sorry, but oh well, I had to do it. I was trying to get this done before Christmas, but sorry, I couldn't get it done. By the way, I've been working on some other vlogs and stuff for my main prank channel on my other channel. It's in the description if you want to check it out. I'll be doing some more pranks and vlogs like that. I got one coming up. I'm gonna shoot my sister with a Nerf gun a lot and make her mad. So make sure to check that out if you haven't. Yeah, I might put it on this channel, but I might actually put it on the other one, though. Ooh, look at how many... God, look how many... There's like at least 35 carts behind us, freight carts. Oh, no. Slow down, slow down, slow down. Sharp turn. Oh, no. We're sliding. See, that's what I was talking about. You can't do that. You got to go super slow on these turns. Now, used to, these trains actually blow black smoke, but that was just because it was burning. The burn was not going as good as it could. It wasn't clean. But when you're burning clean, it ends up being clear gray. And that's how you know it. So we're running a brand new one. Oh, this, I love the tunnels. We got to check out the front of this thing in the tunnel. Look at this. Woo! We're still, see, we're grinding and peeling out too. Woo! Man, I bet it gets hot up in here, man, especially with this steam locomotive going through here. All the everything in there. Well, these are the last of the really big locomotives. These are the last ones, the biggest ones, and then they just went to diesel. But here we are going through final approach, coming up to finally get to our train station. Just blowing the horn, and we got to get through here, and we're almost to there. And here we are. We are pulling up to our final destination. Slowing down to 25, and getting over here. God, look at that sunset. Amazing. Just as the sun is setting and just as the blizzard is cleared. How about that? Wow. Well, this is a super sweet model, and I'm gonna probably do some more stuff relating to the trains. I got one more train coming up, but until then, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. It's pretty sweet. Whew. Gotta slow her down a little bit. And here's the warehouse. We're gonna be dropping off all the cocaine for the next heist. I'm just kidding. But yeah, this thing is pretty much it. Yeah. Oh, slow her down. Get her stopped. And there we go. Brakes on. Engine brake on. There we go. And stop. Let's go ahead and jump out of here. Make sure everything's good. Yeah, it looks like we're parked good. And the regulator's good. All right, let's get out. Up. And that's pretty much it, guys. Wow. Super cold. I wonder if you guys want to see one of these done in regular weather, because I know this is just like a holiday thing, but yeah, I don't know. Let me know what you guys want to see. If you want me to see me do another steam locomotive one with this, another one with this, another video, or do you want me to do like a different locomotive? But I think this is the best one. I think it's the only one I'm going to do. But I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please leave a like on the video. And thanks for watching. Make sure to watch these videos in my outro. With that said, I'll go ahead and end the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.